Tuticorin, often known as the Pearl City, is an industrial district in the Coromandel area of Bay of Bengal. Despite its reputation for being the hub for nuclear and thermal power plants, the city thrives on its fishing exports. Just to give a glimpse of its marine prowess, in Tuticorin, more than 1,300 fishermen produce about 14,000 tons of fish in any given fiscal year. Giant trolleys costing as much as 1.5 crores are employed to conquer the seas and facilitate the seafood appetite of the state. It for sure is a costly affair. These trolleys were bought in the late 60s for a sum total of rupees 1,000 in the day. Most people who own trolleys have inherited it from their fathers. The harbour docks more than 100 ships and have transformed the life of people who were once ordinary fishermen. Prosperity surrounds the trolley business. From workers to the security guard, everyone is paid well, at least making 1,000 rupees per day. Michael, one of the biggest fishermen who owns 4 boats, comments on his success by saying he earns around 40,000 rupees a day, more than what his educated brothers make in a month.
Fifty to sixty years ago, there were no fishing nets. Earlier, there were just hooks when my father used to fish. We were able to fish even then when there were no big boats around. Now the boats cost around 1 to 1.5 crore. We leave at 5 in the morning and come back by 9 in the evening. These boats are really good and fast. We spend around 1 to 1.5 lakhs for one trip. It wasn't always like this. In the beginning, I was in debt. I started working as a boat driver and saved some money to start this with my partner. I was driving even after I owned the boat. The yield was good then, but has declined in the last 10 years.
அப்போ வந்துக்கெல்லாம் மீன்பாடு மீன் துறைகள் நல்லா வந்துச்சுது இப்போ ஒரு ஒரு 10 வருஷமா சுத்தமாக மீன்பாடே இல்லை.
ஓ தட், ஹவ் இஸ் யுவர் பிஸ்னஸ் டூயிங் ரைட் நவ்?
ரைட் நவ் இஸ் குட், பட் ஈவன் சம் சேஞ்சஸ் வில் பிகம் இன் கவர்மெண்ட் ஜிஓ, இட் வில் பி பெட்டர். ஆக்சுவலி தட் வி ஆர் நாட் ஆஸ்கிங் த ஃபண்ட். ஆக்சுவலி வி ஆர் நீட் தட் the timing period actually. So now that the Thoothukudi harbour is only for 5 to 9, around 5 to 10 only the timing is there allotted. Mm-hmm. So only the vessels are only are sent by this period of time only, they are catch the fish, and before that 9 p.m. you will be reached in fishing harbour. This is a very difficult one. So daily expenses are very, very costly. Okay. So these are major, our survival is very, very tough actually. So some relaxation they are giving, mm-hmm. the government mm-hmm. side. So organized is well, mm-hmm. and a small boat mm-hmm. and big boat is a differentiate, separate that the organization will be good, mm-hmm. that not a problem is come actually.
Make sure this is a lot of sequence. Variety of shots and a lot of sequence.
I am Antony. I am 40 years old. I have been working in this fishing business for last 25 years. I get around 10,000 rupees per month. We generally get fishes only for a month in a year. It's mostly shrimps and prawns that we catch. It's tough in the sea.
In the fishermen colony, we met Edwin, who is the president of the local fishermen association.
We are part of the same community. We live like a family. We sometimes have some altercations, but we talk it out and find solution to the problem.
Then there are the small fishermen. They, or members of their families, spend hours every day clearing fishing nets, making baits, and more.
Thank you.
We visited a fisherman's house to understand how they managed to sustain themselves. In the house, we met Jennifer, who spends her day taking care of her disabled brother.
When men are out for fishing, what do women do inside?
We clean the fishes, we sort them, and we sell them in the market. When we aren't doing this, we do the household work.
Are facilities for medicine and hospital available here?
Yes, they are. There's a small hospital and a small medical store just nearby. Nothing big is here. There's just one small government school nearby. If you want to go to a bigger government school, you would have to travel.
How do kids go there?
They have to walk only. There is no safety, but we don't have any choice. If the mother is free, then she'll drop them.
The disparity within the fishing community itself creates two separate identities, one of affluence and one of deprivation. But that doesn't take away the skillfulness and the deterrence to fight against all odds and being content with what life has to offer.